Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to another video from Lingling. In today's video, we are going to talk about Airbnb in China. If you don't know what Airbnb is, well, let me tell you. So Airbnb is a website where you can look up local hosts and then you can rent either a room or a couch, like a shared room, or some kind of thing to sleep on, or the whole apartment. Yes, it's really, really cool because you kind of, if you rent from a local, you might meet them, you might make some new friends, it might be cheaper for you as well. Maybe there are no hotels around, or they're only like super expensive hotels, or maybe, I don't know, it's a really cool way to do it, to try something different from the normal boring hotels. If you, like I, have been traveling a lot, then you also know that hotels are both expensive, but also just very quiet, very boring. So I think Airbnb is a very cool way to spice up your travels. As you know, here in China, almost all foreign media is blocked, like Facebook, Instagram, Google, Gmail, Dropbox, whatever you want to do, it's blocked and you need a VPN. But Airbnb is not blocked yet. That is freaking awesome. A few weeks ago, I was planning to go to Dalian with my friend. It's in northeast China. And I thought, why not try to look around for an Airbnb instead of a hotel? It's mostly because I really want to try to film in different locations. And I feel like hotel rooms are so boring all the time. They look so alike and they're just, yeah, it's just boring. So I was looking around to see if I could find something that looked a little cooler than that. And this is what I found. I'll give you a little tour around. This is what I found. So I found this cool little kind of Instagram looking apartment, which was only 115 RMB a night for the whole apartment, which is freaking amazing because a normal room here in a hotel is, well, we paid 100 RMB for a night for a room without a window. And here we pay 115 for the whole apartment. Yeah, so I'm just gonna go through the process with you guys so you can see that it's actually very easy to use Airbnb in China just as you have used it, you know, everywhere else. And if you're new to it, it's still very simple. So let's just go through the process together here. First, you should sign up to Airbnb. You can check out the link in my description box below. If you go through that link, you'll get $42 off your first trip around town. So that's pretty awesome. You should definitely check that out. Yeah, so you sign up with all your personal information, passport, phone number, and your card. The really cool thing about using Airbnb in China is the fact that you can actually use Zhifubao, the Alipay, to pay with, or I think, I'm not sure if WeChat was allowed to, but you can pay with Alipay, which is freaking amazing because I make money in China, so my money is in China. It's really hard for me to send the money from China to my Danish bank and then pay Airbnb. And also, if I go abroad, I can still use that one. I can still pay with my Alipay. So that's really nice. If you're working in China, you're making all your money here, then it's a really great way to do it. Then next, you just have to figure out where you're going. So you just search for the city. Just as I said before, I wanted to travel to Dalian, so I just wrote Dalian. And then I was looking through the apartments and I was looking at full apartments and also shared rooms and rooms. And I wanted to do a whole apartment because I realized here in Dalian is very cheap. And they have like these small cool apartments where it's just like a one big room, but it's still like sleeping area, living room, and kitchen and bathroom in one for 115 RMB, which I'm still like blown away. It's just so cheap compared to Beijing, you know, if you want to stay in Beijing. So it's just really, really cool. Then I just booked a date when I wanted to come here and stay. And then I received a message from the guy. Actually, first I asked him if it was okay for foreigners to stay in the apartment, because you never really know. There are some funny rules here about like hotels. So I definitely think if you know a little bit of Chinese, so just use Google Translate, but like try to ask the host before you book anything, because it would just be really annoying if you're not allowed to stay there. But then again, on the other side, like here, we're not even like really in touch with the owner. He just sends us the password for the door and then we just come in here, and then when we're done here we just leave. And then yeah, as I said, we don't really talk to the owner at all. But I would just say, just to make sure, you know, just ask in advance, is it okay to foreigners stay where you want to go? That is pretty good. Yeah, it's pretty important. It would be pretty annoying if you come here and they're like, hey, you're a foreigner, you're gonna stay here, bye, and then you're like, oh my god, what am I gonna do now? Yeah, so just saying, guys, just saying. In the message from the guy on Airbnb, it also said that I should add his WeChat, and then I added it, and since then we have just been talking on WeChat, because I wanted to come here a little bit earlier and film a few hours like one of the other days, because we came here on the 23rd and now it's the 27th, so we stayed here from 6 to 7, but we stayed in a hotel, another hotel in another place before that. But then a few days ago I wanted to come here and film during the daytime, so I just asked him like, can we come here because I can see it's empty, and he was like, yeah, that's cool, you know. So I just sent him a bit of money on WeChat and then it was all settled. He gave me the password and everything, so it's been really good. The Wi-Fi is working very nice here. It's quite cold here though, because it's Dalian, it's minus 15 degrees outside, and the inside is not great because there is this huge window, and I literally feel like the air conditioner is working overtime, but literally all the warm wind is just like moving out again, you know. So I would probably think about that if you're going to a really cold place in China. I'd probably ask about the Nuanqi first, if they have like we don't have a radiator here, if they have like radiator, or if they only have the air conditioner, because it's a struggle for the air conditioner here for sure. Anyways, it has been a really good experience and I'll definitely do it again. So as I said, you know, if you want to check it out, check out the link below. You'll get $42 off your first trip. They call it travel credit, I think. So that's pretty cool. I hope that you'll enjoy your stay in China, and yeah, thank you for watching this little video, and remember to follow my social media, Instagram Lenaaround, Facebook Lenaaround, and Patreon Lenaaround, and then I'll see you again very, very soon. Lingling, and 再见. Bye bye.